गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट चैप्टर 4 एटमॉस्फेयर फ्रॉम क्लास 9। यू कैन सी दिस इज द इमेज फ्रॉम द सैटेलाइट, दिस ब्लू लाइन वी आर सीइंग, दिस इज द एटमॉस्फेयर। You can see here, these are the two images of the atmosphere. Now we will see what is the atmosphere. Earth atmosphere is a thin layer of gases that hover above our planet's surface. The atmosphere provides us with oxygen to breathe, shelter us from solar ultraviolet radiation, and warms Earth's surface via the greenhouse effect. So atmosphere is what is a thin layer which cover the earth surface. Now we will see on the basis of chemical composition, the atmosphere is divided into two broad layers, that is homosphere and heterosphere. Now we will see what is the homosphere. Homosphere extends up to a height of 90 km. It consists of three layers, that is troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere. It is characterized by uniformity in composition of gases like nitrogen, oxygen, argon and carbon dioxide. So in homosphere we will see three layers, troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere. Next one is heterosphere. The layer above 90 kilometers of homosphere is called heterosphere. It has a heterogeneous composition and hence the name heterosphere. In this we will see two layers, that is thermosphere and exosphere. Now we will see what are the different layers of atmosphere. The first one is troposphere. It starts at the earth's surface and extends 8 to 14.5 kilometers high. Next one is stratosphere. The stratosphere starts above the troposphere and extends to 50 kilometers. And the next one is mesosphere, then thermosphere, and the last one is exosphere. You can see here layers of atmosphere, troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. The altitude of troposphere is around 20 km, stratosphere is 50 km, mesosphere is 85 km, thermosphere is around 690 km and exosphere is about 10,000 km. In this figure you can see the different layers are there, troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. This is the kilometers range and here you will see the temperature, minus 50 degree centigrade, 0 degree centigrade, minus 85 degree centigrade, 1500 degree centigrade and 2000 degree centigrade. And in the different layers we will see the different transport and natural phenomenon. In the stratosphere and troposphere you will see the aircraft, the formation of clouds take place here, radio sound also will be there. And in the mesosphere you will see the meteors, in thermosphere we will see spacecraft, aurora, and in between the exosphere and thermosphere we will see the satellite. Now we will see what is aurora and meteor. Aurora, a natural electrical phenomenon characterized by the appearance of streamers of reddish or greenish light in the sky, especially near the northern or southern magnetic pole. The effect is caused by the interaction of charged particles from the sun with atoms in the upper atmosphere. In northern and southern regions, it is respectively called aurora borealis or northern lights, and aurora australis are southern light. You can see here the two figure children, the aurora light. Sometimes it will be a reddish light and sometimes it will be a greenish light. Now we will see what is the meteor. A small body moving in the solar system that would become a meteor if it entered the Earth atmosphere. Yeah, you can see here from the space it will enter into the atmosphere, and from the atmosphere it enter into the Earth. Now we will see about the troposphere. This layer is the closest to the Earth's surface. On average, troposphere extends from the ground to about 12 kilometers. The troposphere contains about 75% of all of the air in the atmosphere and almost all of the water vapor which forms clouds and rain. In this layer, air is made up of approximately 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, and 1% argon, with small amounts of additional gases, including the water vapor and carbon dioxide. Now we will see the next layer, stratosphere. This layer of our atmosphere has its own set of layers. The boundary between the stratosphere and troposphere is called as the tropopause. It is the region where airplanes fly. The stratosphere layer extends from the tropopause to about 50 kilometers above the Earth's surface. And in this layer, we will see a ozone molecule which forms a protective layer and absorbs harmful ultraviolet radiation from the sun. The high altitude weather balloons flying into the stratosphere for monitoring atmospheric conditions and climate research. So in the stratosphere, we will see the ozone layer and a high altitude weather balloon flying into the stratosphere for monitoring the atmospheric conditions and climatic research. Now, mesosphere. This layer located above the stratosphere and below the thermosphere. It is the third layer in our atmosphere, which is 35 kilometers thick. The transition boundary which separates the mesosphere from the stratosphere is called as the stratopause. In the mesosphere, fewer air molecules to absorb incoming electromagnetic radiation from the sun. Most meteors burn up in this atmospheric layer. Yeah, whenever the meteor comes from the space, so it burns in this layer. Next one is the thermosphere. This layer has extremely high temperature and located above the mesosphere and below the exosphere. The thermosphere extends from the mesopause to 700 kilometers above the surface of the Earth. The thermosphere is the thickest layer in the atmosphere. Only the lightest gases, mostly oxygen, helium, and hydrogen, are found here. And in this layer, we will see the aurora and satellites mostly occur in this layer. We will see what is the ionosphere. The layer of the Earth atmosphere which contains a high concentration of ions and free electrons and is able to reflect the radio waves. So in this layer, we will see the high concentration of ions and free electrons and is able to reflect the radio waves. The ionosphere is the ionized part of the Earth upper atmosphere from about 48 kilometer to 965 kilometer altitude, a region that includes the thermosphere and the parts of mesosphere and exosphere. The ionosphere is ionized by the solar radiation. So you can see here, in these different layers, you will see the ionosphere. And the next one is the exosphere. The exosphere represents the outermost layer of the Earth's atmosphere. It extends from top of the thermosphere to 10,000 kilometers above Earth's surface. So this is all about the different types of atmosphere. Now, in the next class, we will discuss about pressure belt and planetary winds, air pressure and classification of winds. Before ending this class, I would like to show you a small video.